This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about augmented matrices with 0, 1, or an infinite number of solutions. So when you're working with a system of equations and you're trying to solve them with an augmented matrix, your goal is to get something that looks like this. You want an augmented matrix where the left side is the identity matrix. That means that on the right side, you're going to have the numbers which are the solution to your original equation, or original system of equations. So when this happens, you've got one solution. Now, sometimes it's not going to happen. You might end up with maybe the left part of your augmented matrix having all zeros in the bottom row, and then some number over on the right side. Or you might end up with all zeros in the bottom row, both on the left side and the right side. So what I want to do is explain how this can happen and what it means. Let's start with this system of equations. I've got 2x minus 4y equals 6, and negative 4x plus 8y equals negative 12. And let's try solving this with an augmented matrix. So I'll turn this into 2, negative 4, and 6. That'll be the first row of my matrix. And then negative 4, 8, and negative 12. So my first step would be to get a 1 in the first row, first column position. That means I want to take the first row and multiply it by 1 half and make that into the new first row. So now my matrix is going to become 1 half of 2, which is 1, 1 half of negative 4, which is negative 2, and 1 half of 6, which is 3. And the bottom row stays the same, negative 4, 8, and negative 12. The next step would be to take the element in the second row, first column, and turn that into a 0. So I can do that by multiplying 4 times row 1, adding it to row 2, and making that the new row 2. So the first row stays the same. The second row will become, let's see, 4 times 1 is 4, plus negative 4 is 0. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8, plus 8 is 0. And 4 times 3 is 12, plus negative 12 is 0. So now I've ended up with a bottom row that's all zeros. Here's why that happened. If I go back to the original system of equations, what I can see is that the second equation is really just negative 2 times the first equation. If I multiply that whole first equation by negative 2, I end up with the second equation. When this happens, we say that we've got a dependent system of equations. In other words, we've really only got one equation. If we've really only got one equation, then the graph is just going to be one line, and there's an infinite number of solutions for that line. Okay, so when you end up with a matrix that has all zeros in the bottom row, what that's telling you is you had a dependent system of equations, and you're going to end up with an infinite number of solutions. Now let's look at a different situation. Let's say we've got this system of equations, x plus 2y equals 3, and negative 2x minus 4y equals 8. So let's try to solve this with a matrix. I'll have 1, 2, and 3, and then negative 2, negative 4, and 8. So I've got a 1 as the element in the first row, first column. I want to go down to the second row and turn that negative 2 into a 0. I can do that by multiplying negative 2, I'm sorry, just multiplying 2, times row 1, adding it to row 2, and making that the new row 2. Okay, so the first row stays the same. That's 1, 2, and 3. And the second row will be, let's see, 2 times 1 is 2. 2 plus negative 2 is 0. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 plus negative 4 is 0. And 2 times 3 is 6. And 6 plus 8 is 14. So now I've got a bottom row where I've got zeros on the left side of the matrix, but a 14 on the right side. The reason this happened goes back to the original system of equations. If we multiply that first equation by negative 2, let's do that. If we multiply that first equation by negative 2, what I'm going to get is negative 2x minus 4y, so far this is the same as my second equation, equals negative 6. So now we've got two equations. One says negative 2x minus 4y equals negative 6. The other says negative 2x minus 4y equals 8. When this happens, we say that it's an inconsistent system of equations. If we were to graph this, we would find that we had two lines that were parallel to each other. If they never cross, there's never a solution. In terms of a matrix, what that means is if you end up with a matrix where you've got a row of zeros on the left side of the matrix and then a number on the right side, what you've got is an inconsistent system and there are going to be zero solutions. Okay, so just to review your options. If you end up with something like this, where you've got the identity matrix on one side of your matrix and then numbers on the right side, you've got one solution. If you end up with a matrix that has all zeros on the bottom, then you've got a dependent system and you've got an infinite number of solutions. If you end up with zeros in the bottom row on the left side of the matrix and a number on the right side in that row, that means you've got an inconsistent system and you've got no solutions. And that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.